Hi, I will show you what's new in the hair tool. So first we have new strand generator called Strands from 2D UV pattern. So if you have base mesh with UVs, they are not non-overlapping UVs. We can use those UVs to spawn a bunch of points, and then those points are converted to hair strands. So this is useful for feathers because they often go in those stripes like patterns, and we have few patterns to select from, like Fibonacci disk, Fibonacci squares, grid, etc. And this would not work too good with the normal strand generation, because if I select normal strand generation and let's bump density, the issue is that we do not get any flow in those strands. So this is completely random, and this is now how feathers are distributed. One example when I used those, this new method is, for example, in this build preset, we can now very uniformly spawn strands on the mesh UVs. So this is the source mesh, and one interesting way to control density using this new strand generator is just by scaling the UV layout up, because this way, if you, for example, imagine we got like few points in here, and let's say we have plane that covers with its UV 4 points. Now, if we scale this UV for the plane, we make it bigger. Now you see it will cover more points, so it's like more density will be spawned in the area where you scale UVs. So for example, if I use soft selection and scale those UVs like so, you see we get more density of the hair strands in this area. So instead of using vertex groups, I can just go maybe to this area, scale this down, and now we have less strands spawned in here. Another useful feature is now ability to subdivide only sharp corners in the strands. So in the resample, subdivide at angle, now you see this is smoother. So let's preview this maybe. I will add more subdivisions. So like before and after. The advantage is that, for example, in this hairstyle, we do not have enough resolution on the bottom, and previously you would have to like subdivide whole strands just to get smoother result in the bottom. But if I now enable subdivide at angle, now we get smoother result and the poly count will not explode. So there is improvement in the strands from grid surface. Let's say I have bunch of mesh islands and I want to spawn strands from those islands. Now they will use the length of this first segment to determine amount of the strands generated. So what I mean by that, without normalization, when I set strand count to 10, we will spawn 10 strands on each like segment in here. With normalization, shorter distances will spawn less strands. But what if I want more control? Like maybe I want to divide the amount of strands in this first mesh island by 2. Well, now I can use a vertex group like this one, where I reduce the weight by 50%. And now if I use this density mask input, mask that by vertex group, you see now we are spawning less strands. So you have more precise control over where to spawn a given amount of strands. Another improvement in the strands from grid is this new use strand count as density. So let's say I want to copy the whole hair system from the discrete mesh to discrete mesh in here. Now the issue is that we are spawning 50 strands, which is enough for those two mesh islands, but this is not 30 is not enough for this long mesh island. So I would have to like make this hair system unique, then I could increase density like so, but now those hair systems are no longer connected. So instead I will undo, and now I will use strand count as density. And with 30, it means we are spawning 30 strands per 1 meter. Let's bump this up to 200, still not enough. Let's bump this up to 2000. And now this works okay. And both hair systems are now shared. So I can tweak one and both will be affected. There is now new trim hair strands by mesh. So I have this sphere. I can use this to trim strands in this hair system. And now when I move the sphere, you get this kind of effect. There is now new straighten strands, so this is how it looks, and I can change influence range to move the effect closer to the roots. And for example, on this hairstyle, I can switch influence range mask type to simple root to tip, root to tip. And now when I increase the straighten on the roots, you get this kind of effect. So now it is using the root point tangent, so that's why it is using this direction. But I can use align to normal. This then it will use the surface normal for alignment. Okay, so maybe you know that in the hair tool we use the factor attribute in the hair shader. It looks like that. And this black and white mask is used for masking root color and tip color in the shader. So if I show you quickly, I can change the tip color, change the root color like so. Now in the past, this gradient would be always going from black to white. You could not customize that, but now you can use this factor set attribute. And thanks to that, you can, for example, like invert this effect. Or in this case, for example, I do not want the shorter strands to go to completely white. So I can mask value with length mask. And for the shortest strands, set them to like 40% of maximum brightness. Another interesting case where this could be used. We have the hairstyle made with two layers. The base layer has factor set to darker value of around 70%. Then the top layer has factor set to 100%. So without that, you would get very uniform, plain, boring look to hair. And then if I increase the second layer brightness, we get this more like interesting shapes, more contrast and fake-like shadow effect. Now you can finally preview input mask in the 3D viewport. So for this randomize, press this light bulb icon, and when I change randomize amplitude, you see this is how it works. The black strands will receive less amplitude, since dark color means the value is close to zero, and the zero times any noise amplitude will result in zero noise. Then I am adding offset gain, which basically works as contrast for this mask. I can also preview this influence range, and you see we get zero noise applied to the roots because it is black, tiny bit in the center, and then full noise is applied to the endings. Lastly, for this pushout, we again use randomize, and then a matte mask. This matte mask is making so that every second strand only is selected, and when I change the pushout value, you see only the white strands are affected. You just can click right click to cancel the preview in the 3D viewport. So the last change I wanted to show is that the system color can be now set not only to hue saturation value, but also to RGB type. Now the system color attribute, I can show you in the shader, It is used in here. When it is black, it will be mixed in additive way with base color. So when we add black to base color, it doesn't change anything. If I set this to red, now the red channel, red is added to the base color. So for example, I could put randomize mask onto red to get this kind of effect in the red. Then I would increase green to 1, and I could put maybe the influence range mask. So this would be the green channel. And lastly, I could put maybe in the blue channel the length mask. So this would be the blue channel. So those are the biggest changes I wanted to show. Hope you like the update. See ya.